My name is James Kozloski. I'm a research staff member at IBM Research, and I've been modeling the brain for 15 years in the computational biology department. So we're in Yorktown Heights, New York. We're walking on a trail that winds its way through, and it's actually quite beautiful. Understanding the brain is the grandest of challenges, I think, because it's really personal. It's a question of what it is that I am that we're ultimately trying to answer, or what it is that makes a brain different from other sort of systems or structures that we can build or observe in the universe. So when one looks at the brain, you're struck immediately by the complexity of the structure itself. Just like this forest is complex, the brain is orders of magnitude more complex. From looking at the brain and its components as a single system, we'll be able to solve some of the more difficult problems in behavior, learning, neurodegenerative, and other disorders of the brain. In the case of memory, I was working with some co-inventors around applications of the technology that was just growing, that is cognitive computing and Watson. And we had each had experiences with loved ones and relatives who had Alzheimer's disease, where memory sort of starts to go wrong at an early stage of mild cognitive impairment. What we thought was there could be a way to use technology to kind of process the context that individuals in and prompt the individual when they stumble or they can't remember what comes next. It's part of our model that the brain is preparing sort of to deploy behaviors constantly. What that means is that you may be able to pick up signals that are sort of precognitive in the way our heart is beating or the way we're breathing, that are predictive of states that might emerge minutes or even tens of minutes later. So an example would be if I'm thinking I want to, let's say, go and eat something that's not good for me, or talking to someone and I realize that I'm not behaving the way that I would like to. Maybe in the future, if you can predict it, I would benefit from that prediction and take a different action, just like how I wear different clothes when I get the weather report. So there's a whole host of applications for this. One that we're exploring now has to do with clinical trials and understanding when people are feeling that a drug is working or when they're feeling that it's not working. I think of individuals as becoming sort of more able to get answers, solve problems, and be more effective in the environment by having this type of technology to assist them.